black hoodie, I'm back cooking these goodies. Look at these views from cooking these foods, yeah.
Hello, and welcome to another installment of This Strange Thing That I Do on the Internet. Today, we have some Greek food, and I am terribly starving, and I'm ready to just dive into it. So without further ado, before we do anything more, we must pour. We have our clear glass, our Diet Dr. P. We crack. And we pour. Extra aggressive on the foam on the fizz today, but we can deal with it. Moment of silence for the Fountain of Youth. Coming closer to the first sip, and we have arrived. Shake it off, shake it up, get that ice to pop up, and we go in for a first sip. There's no words to describe it. It's just in its own realm. All right, so we've got some souvlaki skewers. These are chicken. We have a nice traditional Greek salad with the cucumber, tomato, Kalamata olives, red onion, and feta. Couple pita breads here. All in all, these are adding up to about 55 grams of carbs. Why am I mentioning that? Because, as you could probably tell by now, I'm going very low carb, a little more healthy. I'm going to do this month, so we'll talk about it. We can explain. But right off top, I do want to make myself like a sort of sandwich type deal, you know? So the first thing we're going to have to do is grab some of this thick tzatziki. And just get it right in there. Adhesive, baby, adhesive. And then just strip one of these chicken skewers into there. Probably do like a half of another one. Right. Maybe another little dash of that fine sauce that we have here. And then fill it in with some salad. This, ladies and gents, is a beautiful, delicious, fresh option. Can't go wrong with any of that. Do you know what I mean? Extremely ready for this. Always gotta have extra tzatziki. Getting freaky with tzatziki. Tzatziki sauce is hands down one of the best sauces to ever do it. So thick. We're bursting out the back. No. Where are you going? Crotch drops. End this right. The proper depth. What a fantastic start to the meal. So, I had some of that dressing left over. And I love a ton of dressing. But because of the tomatoes, this salad is certainly quite juicy already. I love Greek salads so much. The olives. Just make it amazing. It's just not quite the same when you get it without the olives. And I just simply dressed it with canola oil, white wine vinegar, salt, pepper. That's it. Perfect. So yeah, just a little, I guess, heads up at this point for this month. Keeping it low carb, keeping it keto. And basically, the reason for that is I just went so hard in December. I ate everything terrible, especially for the channel. And I gotta reel it in for my body. Now, I did that on purpose because, little insider YouTuber information, December is the most amazing month on YouTube in terms of money. Earning. So it was worth it to go hard. Conversely, January is the worst. January is like the most, like the lowest earning month for just everybody, that the platform just drops off in terms of the ad revenue. So it's an opportune moment for me just to like accept like a shitty month. You know, don't try to kill myself with the terrible foods. It's a good time for me to take a moment to just cut like 10 pounds, maybe 15 even. We'll see. I'm intrigued to tell you at the end of the month how many I've lost. But yeah, I know that my views are gonna tank a little bit and it's not gonna be as good as usual, but I've mentally just accepted that and this month as what it is. And I'm just at peace with it. Because to be honest, that's what I need this month. Honest, like I just feel it in myself, in my soul. Like I feel like I've been grinding really hard on YouTube since July, and just really, really going and spending a lot of waking hours just thinking a lot and stressing a lot, and you know, kind of just in a bad space. And I don't want to just like disappear and quit. Like I still want to just be consistent. But I need to allow myself a good month of just, you know, no attachment to outcome. Less constant ruminating on, you know, how am I gonna achieve this, do that, whilst ruining my body. The cool thing about these videos is, and I mean, there's probably not many people left watching at this point, but the cool thing about these videos is it actually shows me who the true G's are, like who the riders are, who are the people that are actually showing up no matter what is on the plate. And it's nice for me to get a gauge on that. See how many of y'all I really got with me instead of the plate. And just to get to establish those names and those profile pictures, and you know, see who's really out here for that, for like the real shit. But I totally understand people wanting to come and watch the dirty food, the fast food, because you know, we all have our different things, and a lot of people want to eat that shit, but they can't. And it's a way for them to kind of do it without doing it. And maybe this will be a good little change up for a little while for the people who like more natural, homemade type foods, to kind of get that fix if they've been craving it, you know? Because I love these type of foods. Home cooked, healthy, is A-okay with me. I like them. Big vegetable fan. Well, if you made it this far, you're a G. You're a real one. Hope you enjoyed it. Till the next one, you know what to do. Eat good, live well. Stay true.